See anybody? Is it synonymous with abortion or is it different from abortion? Medical termination of pregnancy.
Termination of pregnancy before the fetus is viable, ma'am.
Yeah, termination of pregnancy before the fetal viability is also abortion. Is there anything different? Is MTP different from abortion?
It is a legal abortion done under specific conditions.
Okay, good. So it is a willful termination of pregnancy before the period of viability. Yes, good. It all correctly. So it is a willful termination. See, voluntarily the couple or the patient is wanting to have a termination of pregnancy for various reasons, whether it usually it is a medico-legally approved reasons that you are doing a termination of pregnancy. So that will become MTP. So it's a willful termination of a pregnancy before the period of viability. Whereas abortion is only a spontaneous termination. Nature is deciding the process of termination of pregnancy before the period of viability. That is abortion. Okay. I think you got a difference. You noted the difference. So here it is a voluntary or a willful termination of pregnancy is MTP. Whereas it is spontaneous termination where you label it as abortion. Now, you all know till 2021, till this year beginning, the period of viability was considered as 20 weeks. So any termination of pregnancy below this period of viability is supposed to be MTP. But now, what is the new law saying? Any idea? What is the new law telling you about the medical termination of pregnancy? What is the new law? Do you have any idea about the new MTP Act? Anybody? What modifications did it make to the new older MTP Act? Okay, so one of you in my next session will tell me what is the new MTP law saying, what are the criteria that it has changed under which MTP can be done. So anybody can just volunteer and tell me about the new MTP guidelines. In my next session, you will do a talk for 10 minutes on that MTP guidelines. Anybody? Is anybody there?
Yes, ma'am.
What is your number, doctor?
72, ma'am.
See, why you people are not interacting? If you are not interested, I already told you last time, you can please openly tell us. If you are not interested, we will not waste time taking the class. We have clinical work to be done in the hospital. We are not just coming and sitting, and so we are having a lot of time to waste on these classes. Please give your clear opinion through your CR. Anonymously, you can give the opinion to CR, or if you want, you can forward it to me also to my mobile number, which you can take from Dr. Ramesh, from Ramesh or Dr. Shruti. And you can simply forward your personal opinion about the classes. If you do not want classes, you can as well open up and tell me. Because I am finding it very difficult. If you don't interact, I will not know whether my class is worth taking or not. Did you understand? Roll number 72, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Is there any practical problem that you're not finding these sessions interesting? Is it like that? What is your opinion? Yes or no, you tell me. I am not going to decide your final exam result based on this answer now. Are they boring like sessions?
No, ma'am.
Then why are your friends not, none of you, the ones who are answering only are answering? That is what I personally feel. Even if I ask some question, there's a lot of latency. I don't see, at least the last year batch of students to whom we took the same sessions, they were interacting, they were talking something, more than one person was answering. But this batch, somehow I feel there is some problem. you can please express, you feel that the way we are talking or we are doing these sessions is not giving you the right message, then we will change our paternal abortions and maternal deaths. See, until it was made a law, even the doctors did not find it safe to do the MTPs. Okay, so all the cases which the doctors were refusing with the fear that it is not justified to do MTP, the patients were going to these quacks or they were resorting to some non-scientific ways of going and having abortions, and that was resulting in criminal abortions and deaths of the woman. So with the formulation of this MTP Act 1971, abortions became safe and maternal deaths also have come down drastically. And even from the doctor's point of view also, they felt protected because they had a solid reason to do an abortion. So doctors are also were willing to do abortions. Like that, the MTP Act provided benefit to both the patient as well as to the doctors. And according to this act, it said that MTP can be done up to 20 weeks of pregnancy only. But the latest act or the law that is promulgated or forwarded in March 2021 has raised this cutoff, the gestation age, to 24 weeks. But again, to that 24 weeks cutoff, it has put some conditions or criteria when you can go up to 24 weeks. So now the new law has elevated this age of doing MTP. So it has become now 24 weeks. So shortly, maybe your next the MTP, it says that MTP can be done under medical grounds, eugenic grounds, then humanitarian grounds and social or economic grounds. What are medical grounds? Suppose if you feel that pregnancy, continuation of pregnancy is endangering the life of a pregnant woman, affecting both her physical and mental health, like she has a heart disease. Okay, she continues the pregnancy up to term, then that heart disease may get exacerbated and the patient may die because of the complication of the heart disease and pregnancy. So if that type of an indication is there, then you can terminate the pregnancy, and provided she comes to you before that cutoff of 20 to 24 weeks. Okay. Then what do you mean by eugenic grounds? Eugenic grounds means if the fetus itself is abnormal because of a congenital malformation, which will not allow the fetus to survive after delivery or after birth, then again you can terminate that pregnancy. Or you find that that fetus is having some hereditary disorder, like a hemophilia or some other condition where they cannot live with that disease, then also you can terminate the pregnancy. Or unknowingly, the woman got exposed to a teratogen, that means she took some medication which will cause harmful effects on the fetus, then also you can terminate the pregnancy. Or the mother had some infection like a rubella, which can cause a congenital abnormality to the fetus, then also you can terminate. So all these are come under eugenic grounds for terminating a pregnancy. Then what is humanitarian grounds? When do you say that you are doing MTP under humanitarian grounds? Is when you are doing an MTP for a pregnancy that is resulting from a rape, or when a pregnancy has occurred in an unmarried girl or in a widow. That is a humanitarian grounds. Then when do you say that MTP is being done for social or economic grounds? Is when the pregnancy is affecting her social status or a financial status, then also you can decide and go ahead and do an MTP. So these are all different grounds that are medico-legally accepted for doing an MTP. And then there are some special situation called if the pregnancy is resulting from a failed tubectomy or a failed contraceptive measure, like if the woman had some property contraception, but that though the property is in situ, accidentally sometimes it happens that the woman may conceive because of a displaced property. Property got displaced from its normal position, so the woman conceived. So in that condition, again, you can go ahead and do an MTP and then prevent her from having that unwanted pregnancy. Then suppose if the woman had a tubectomy done and spontaneously the tubes got canalized, recanalized, and it resulted in a failed tubectomy and a pregnancy, then also you can do a MTP. So these are all special conditions where you can proceed and do a MTP. Then place for performing an MTP, when in which all places you can perform MTP. any hospital or an institution approved by the government under the MTP Act, then the doctor should have been trained for doing an MTP. And then what are the things that you should take care of is you should select the case properly. You should see whether that woman is fitting into that criteria of eugenic grounds, social grounds, health grounds. So if the condition for doing MTP is fitting into one of those grounds, then it is a proper selection of the case. Then you do all the relevant investigations there to know her blood group, to know her HIV status, blood sugars, hemoglobin level, and then proceed for MTP. And then if it is a pregnancy below 3 months, an opinion of one doctor for doing MTP is sufficient. Whereas if it is 20 weeks and beyond, you have to take the opinion of two doctors. And then you have to have some consent taken on particular forms. And then you should also maintain the data of the patient in your hospital. Why she came? Why did you do the MTP? What was the method of doing MTP? Was the consent taken on? So all those criteria also you should maintain as a register with you in the hospital. And then if the person is an unmarried girl, less than 18 years, the consent of a legal guardian, whether it is a father, mother, or somebody who is taking the responsibility of the patient, should be signing before you proceed for MTP. So these are some of the legal implications in doing an MTP. So with this, I'll stop here and proceed in my next session. Thank you.